meet Joe Pulido, age 15. Joe Pulido grows up in Colony, New York, known for its mean streets and thuggish talk.
Check it, knuckle!
What up? Oh.
Joe Pulido is going to defy all odds. Once an All-American football player, he has decided to become a Dave Matthews impersonator. Meet Dave Matthews, Joe Pulido's hero. This is the man Joe aspires to be, and he hopes that with his music, he will change the mean streets of Colony. This is Joe Pulido. At the moment, he is mentally preparing for the concert coming up in 2 weeks. Joe hopes that with his music, he will inspire the people of Colony to no longer be thuggins anymore. Now Joe, what made you decide to stop playing football and to pursue this singing career?
Well, I don't have a real reason. I just wanted to be like Dave Matthews, my hero.
Now, what about Dave Matthews inspires you so much? Is it his music? How he writes his lyrics? Explain.
Well, it's a certain song. It's called Warehouse. I just love the piano and stuff. Even though it's not a piano, it's a guitar.
Yeah, I got you. Now, you have an upcoming concert in 2 weeks. Are you prepared yet? Like, have you practiced enough that you are going to be ready for this concert next week?
Well, I have my trainer, Corey Comptill. He's been helping me a lot.
Now, what type of things do you do?
Well, I listen to Rocky music to get me pumped. Play hardcore rock. And then I go soft. Like Dave Matthews, my idol.
I see. A normal person at the weight room works out like Matt Jr., working his chest muscles, making them chiseled for the ladies. But Joe Pulido, on the other hand, works out a different way.
Come on, baby. Five more, bitch. Come on. Yeah.
Meet Corey Comptill, Joe Pulido's mentor, friend, and trainer. Corey's been with Joe through the hard times and the good times. And he's never left his side because he's a good friend. Now, Corey, what made you stick by Joe this long and become his trainer?
Boogie, now listen up, Boogie. This boy has a lot of potential, Boogie. Now, I've been with this boy through the hard times and rough times. Back in the war, I lost a lot. This kid's got it all.
Did he put something inside you that you never had before?
A penis. A penis. A penis. See, back in Nam, some landhead gook walked right up to me. Alright, see, back in the day, they had these rice hats, Boogie. They took a knife right out, pulled my pants down, and ripped off my penis.
So, what do you use these days? Like, I mean, you said that he gave you something. What was it, emotionally, mentally? Like, what was it?
No. You see, nowadays, they call them artificial wings. Now, just watch this bad boy. Find it. Yo. Good winner.
Now, Corey, back to the interview after we were a little distracted, which was kind of disturbing. What type of training do you do on Joe to like get him ready for concerts?
Well, as you've seen before, we use his guitar and recording guitar push-ups. You betcha, basically. But yeah. I got a nice one. Joe, ball. These are called medicine ball bounce off your motherfucking head.
Me, coach. Ready, go. Hey. You missed me, coach. All right, coach, one more. I'm gonna try to get this.
Ready, baby?
I missed you, coach. We gotta get a good one.
As you can see, this gets very intense. The drama going through this, I couldn't believe. Now, Corey, is there any other training sessions that you like to do with Joe? Any other activities?
Oh, baby. I got a special. See, this one, I like to call it Keep the Rhythm. What are you thinking? Get it right.
Oh, coach!
As I was watching, I was very disturbed. Now, although there are many supporters of Joe, not everyone is confident in what he's doing. and most people don't agree.